Welcome back to my channel. It's World Watercolour Month, day 26, and the prompt for today is natural wonders. So I thought I would have a go at one of those fantastical sort of skyscapes that you see. Is that a word? Skyscape's a thing? If it isn't, it should be. But my inspiration is the Northern Lights. I've never seen them in person myself, so I've been looking at lots of different photos. And I think painting them in watercolour is very helpful because it's quite easy to get those soft edges. It's also quite easy to make a bit of a mess of it, but it's fun either way, I have to say. So in order to achieve those soft edges and no hard lines, you saw me begin by spraying the whole sheet of paper. And because I knew I was going to do that, I taped it down to a board, and I'm just using packing tape for that. Now that bit that I'm wiping up, you can see I didn't actually press the packing tape down firm enough, so I'm not going to have that perfect clean border. It also means I'm going to probably get cauliflowers in that area, but you know, never mind. We press on. So I just drop in my colours in sort of swooping marks, thinking a little bit about the sort of composition I'm going for, and making sure that I can try and eliminate any edges by applying wet on wet. And a few times I bravely go back in with my spray bottle, you just saw me do that, to re-mist the paper to get it damp again. And the spray bottle is a good gentle way of doing that, but you do risk the odd cauliflower. And you can see, we're now in sort of day two, because I had to let that dry completely, that that is what happened. There are a couple of cauliflowers in there, but to be honest, I love them. They're so pretty. So I will just press on and live with that. Now, the reference I was working from had some sort of interesting water in the foreground, which was reflecting those beautiful lights in the sky. So I thought I'd have a go at doing that. And it's a good chance to cover up any of the bits I don't like. And that part that I'm painting now, in hindsight, once I'd finished, I'd rather wished I'd lifted that up a bit to cover the blue blob I put at the top. But you know, never mind. It's awfully fun to paint in layers. I don't often do it because I don't normally have the patience to wait for things to dry for the whole day. But when you do, you get the sort of glow of the underneath colour shining through. Thank you for watching. See you again next time.